So BB guns are pretty fun to play with, right? Here we have the Red Ryder BB gun, made infamous by the phrase, you'll shoot your eye out from Christmas Story. We're probably going to have to take some caution because this is probably the most powerful BB gun on the market right now. Now, obviously, I was kidding about the Red Ryder BB gun being the most powerful on the market. It's not anywhere close. But here at High Speed Fanatics, we sort of like to start simple. So real quick, let's just run through our setup that we have here. As you can see, the first thing we're going to be shooting is a can of Dr. Pepper soda. Here's our high-speed camera, of course. There's our laptop. And we have Grace on the all-important triggering, which is... Where is it, Grace? Where is it? Right there. And I will be standing right here to shoot the soda. So to get the most violent reaction out of this, we're gonna shake it up. So we have a lot of carbon bubbles introduced to add pressure. You ready?
Yep. Same thing as last time.
And 3, 2, 1, trigger. There is the damage that we induced with our BB gun. So now, as you can see, I have a yardstick attached here, and we're actually going to examine the muzzle velocity of this BB gun. So now we're going to try to pop a balloon. The BB gun. You ready? 3, 2, 1. Chris. So now we have a CD standing up on its edge with a clever contraption of scotch tape. And that's our next target. 2, 1, trigger. Put a hole right through it. So now I'm going to test my marksman skills by shooting a pretzel rod. 2, 1, trigger. Did that top part spin in the air? So now that we've done our damage, we're going to head inside and take a look at the footage. Gonna end the video?
Sure.
So out of the many things that we wanted to shoot with a BB gun, while deciding
we both sort of first came up with this first idea, which was to shoot a soda can. I think we both thought that would be pretty interesting to do. And so we have Dr. Pepper. Usually we have like Coke or Pepsi or something on our show. But today we chose to go neutral and go with Dr. Pepper because we both like Dr. Pepper. Yeah, here, which was shot at 2,500 frames per second. So you'll notice that the way that the pellet enters the soda and the way it exits this can is very different. We have sort of a small entry hole here, and it sort of just comes a little bit out. But then by the time the pellet gets to the back, it's more like an explosion. And the reason for this is something called hydrostatic shock. Basically, whenever a projectile or something that's moving extremely fast enters a substance that is mostly a liquid, it induces something called hydrostatic shock. And essentially what happens is, as this pellet enters the fluid has to get out of the way because water is incompressible. It cannot be compressed. So it has to move out of the way. And so this partial vacuum is being induced in this fluid. And as the fluid expands, it has to go somewhere. And so it's forcing a pressure out on all sides of the can. And when this pellet breaks through the back end, that now gives it a place to go. And so that's why you see this sudden rush coming out and just pushing so hard that the can actually slices open and we have a much bigger exit hole. And here's the same thing filmed four times slower at 10,000 frames per second. And this shot is a lot cooler than the last one. I would say it probably takes about 10,000 frames per second to really slow down this BB. Because before we got some like really long streaks that were just going across the screen really quickly. But here we can actually see it traveling over quite a bit of time. See, it makes its entrance, and you see a little vibration traveling around the soda can. And right now the pellet is tearing through this soda, making this partial vacuum in there. And so imagine like a V shape, like sort of going around this pellet. Sort of how when a boat goes through water, it's got like the V shape going through it. So imagine that going on. And so we have this high pressure pushing out this way, which is pretty much why the soda doesn't come back out and explode this way. So we have a lot of force going forward and up and down. And when this pellet breaks through the back end, that allows for it to break through. And it's sort of a strange thing. When you first watch it, the soda can actually came back at me, which at first glance is sort of confusing because you think if I hit it going this way, it should keep going that way. Because you would think that's what Newton's laws would say. But when you take a closer look, you see that Newton's laws still do apply, but all of this soda being pushed this way, that's where your equal and opposite force is going to come from. And it has to push the can the other way to make up for that. This shot right here is probably the fastest frame rate we've done on the show, not counting the pilot episode where we're popping the balloons. We ran this at 25,000 frames per second, which is over 1,000 times slower than what you can see with your eye. And so the end of the barrel is probably somewhere around here, and because I didn't want it to slow down in the air too much before it got to the point where we would start measuring it. And you see I started at, these are inches by the way, the 10-inch mark, and I wanted to get 4 inches of travel within the field of view to get a good estimate of its velocity. So there we have the BB traveling. And if we start it at where the edge of the BB is at 10 inches, we can count 30 frames before the edge of it touches the 14-inch mark. So it has traveled 4 inches and 30 frames at 25,000 frames per second, which, when doing the division, 0.0012 seconds, which is not very long at all. So this thing's moving fairly fast. Since we know how far this is going and we know how long it's taking now, since velocity is distance over time, it's basically just a division problem, and we end up getting 3,333 inches per second, which is not very helpful because we don't really know what that means, because inches per second is not very common. So if we convert that to feet per second, we end up getting around 270. And after looking up at the internet, the specs on this BB gun, I saw estimates between, I think, 250 and 300 feet per second, which is accurate. I mean, we've basically proven that this can travel within that range of velocity. So if you're ever skeptical, just grab your local high-speed camera and film the projectile and then do your basic kinematic equations to basically prove or disprove whether or not that's true. So here on High-Speed Fanatics, we really like popping balloons. that's what we did in the pilot, and that was our first episode. It had to deal with balloons. So obviously we had to pop a balloon with the BB. All of these shots are being done at 2,500 and 10,000 frames per second. And so again, this BB isn't being slowed down very much. We only get basically 3 frames before this has entered the balloon. And you'll notice that the BB actually pushes into the balloon quite a bit before it even punctures it. And we have like a little bit of a line right there of tearing. And then you can actually see the BB right there traveling inside of the balloon. This is almost traveling at the same rate that the balloon's popping, which is pretty interesting. And so it meets it at the back right there and tears through again by the time the balloon is popped, which is pretty crazy to see. So now that we've slowed this down to 10,000 frames per second, we get a much better look and angle on how this BB is penetrating this balloon, because it's traveled probably about a fifth to a fourth of the way through the balloon before this tear starts to generate on the side of it. And we can see it travel up and around. And again, the BB gets to pretty much the end of the side of the balloon by the time this whole thing has popped, which sort of gives us an idea of how quickly balloons pop.
Okay, so we set up the CD on somehow on its side, Bryce figured it out, and we wanted to see if it would either crack or if it would puncture it like with just a hole from the BB.
I expected it to just shatter the CD.
Me too.
Did you? Yeah. That first shot was a little bit of a letdown. I'm sure it was to you as well. Yeah, here it is. And basically we just get this little hole with a few cracks coming off of it. That was a little bit disappointing. But we do have a couple frames here where we actually have the moment of contact right there. We have these little tiny cracks coming off, and basically the BB is actually touching the CD right now. And then one frame later, the cracks have generated a little bit more, and the BB just travels on through, and we have a lot of leftover force in the CD causing it to vibrate, which sort of disrupted my very clever contraption of scotch tape to fall apart.
So this time we actually managed to shatter the CD, mostly, by hitting just the plastic ring in the middle.
And I think that's because of the different types of materials put into the CD. Most of it is covered in or contains plastic, but this part here is just plastic, and that has whatever materials put into the part where the laser inputs the data onto the CD. And you can see, as this BB hits it, it doesn't go through it. Which means this is either a thicker plastic or a different type of plastic. I'm not very sure. But basically, the density of whatever that material is was much higher. And since the BB couldn't just penetrate straight through it, almost all of the force went into the CD, which means it got a much more violent reaction. If you look at the streak right there, the BB's going that fast during that exposure time. And since the exposure time coming off of it is much smaller, it means it's traveling much slower coming off. And that's what tells me that a lot of energy from the BB was put into the CD. And being so flimsy and made of plastic, it just basically just falls apart. This shot of shooting the pretzel was more of a test for my marksman abilities with the BB gun. I wasn't like 50 yards away or anything like extreme. I was a moderate distance away, you know. And it wasn't really a difficult shot. We just wanted to hit the pretzel and see what happened. When I first saw this, you heard me in the video say, asking if that top part spun in the air, which it did, obviously. But that's mostly due to the way that two solid, hard things interacting with each other will behave, because solids don't really give way when they're impacted by something else, as like fluids do. And so basically once this hits, everything in that solid is going to react pretty much at once. And so when we have a force here inside of the pretzel, once it breaks it in half, we have two different rigid bodies that are going to act on their own now, not as one. And since this was attached to the chair, the bottom part doesn't really move much. But on this top part here, we have a force going this way, and this isn't moving, and so the only thing for this top part to do is to spin. And then of course we had all the pretzel in between, now shattered into a lot of crumbs, just going everywhere. And so now I brought the camera closer so we could get a closer up shot of how this BB is impacting this pretzel, again at 10,000 frames per second. And really this just gives us a better opportunity to examine how these two bodies are interacting with each other. And you see, even after the first frame of it contacting the pretzel, all this pretzel up here is already starting to rotate it. It's difficult to see because the resolution isn't too great, but all of the pretzel is now reacting to this. This is going to deattach, this is going to move a little bit, all these crumbs are going to fly off, and that's all been decided right now in this very instance that I have right here. Yeah, so as you can see on HighSpeedFanatics, we're starting to get into the more elaborate, advanced things to film. And you saw we started out with the really basic things, water balloons, skateboarding, stuff like that. And now we're starting to get into BB guns. We're probably going to have stuff on explosions eventually. We're starting to get to the more exciting topics. Yeah, so for now you can subscribe for the episode we'll have next week and the week after. And like our videos, share with your friends, and we'll see you next week. Thanks for watching this week's episode of High Speed Fanatics. You can follow us on Twitter at username HighSpeedFans.
You can also find us at Facebook.com/HighSpeedFanatics.
If you have any questions or suggestions, please feel free to send us an email at highspeedfanatics@gmail.com.